Channel. I do hope that everyone has had a safe week. I pray that this week has been all that you have wanted it to be. I hope that everyone is still practicing social distancing, excuse me, and safe hygiene. I just want to say thank you all for tuning in, and I hope you guys enjoy my video today. So today's video is about dealing with rejection, and not looking at rejection as a no, but looking at rejection as a redirection. So today's Bible verse comes from Philippians 4:6, and it reads, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your request to God." Okay, so what is being anxious? Anxious is like feelings of uneasiness. And sometimes when we go through things where we're rejected or we're told no, going forward in similar situations, we can expect to feel a little bit of anxiety. And you might feel a little bit of anxiety or feel anxious because when we're rejected in certain situations, we feel all type of emotions. You know, we feel worry, we feel fearful, excuse me. We feel like, you know, that our world has kind of ended. And like I said, moving forward, when we're trying to do things that were similar to the things that we were rejected in, it gets scary because, for one, no one likes to get rejected. No one wants to get told no. And it's just, you ask yourself the question, like, am I doing the right thing or is it the right time? And sometimes being denied of the things that we want so badly can make us feel less than, and it can even make us feel as though, you know, we're not meant to have those things. And I'm just here to tell you that that's just not the case, because sometimes God doesn't allow us to have certain things because he's redirecting us in a direction that is so much better for us. And when you allow God to direct you towards the path that he sees fit rather than the path that you see fit, you see that things began to fall into place, because God can see the end of a situation from the beginning. And just out of the love for you, he stops you from heading down that path of destruction with rejection sometimes. Like, for example, a relationship maybe that you wanted, and you wanted this relationship really, really bad. And at the time, you know, it's like all of a sudden you're snatched out of that relationship, and you just don't see why. But as God begins to carry you down the path that he's directing you down, and it's just like, you see, like, why did you want the relationship in the first place? Like, you see all the things that God was protecting you from when he pulls you out of a situation, and then you begin to dwell on it and reminisce and look backwards, and you see that he was only saving you from you. And when God blocks things, that's not him saying that you don't deserve those things. That's just him saying that I have something better for you in store. I just need you to not only be patient, I need you to have faith, and I need you to trust me and trust my way, and know that my ways are the right ways, and know that I have prepared something so much better than that thing that you feel like you lost. And then you moving forward, you kind of you're fearful because you might, I don't want to make the same mistake that I've been making over and over again. So while it seems as though, you know, you were being rejected, I mean, in all actuality, you were kind of learning how to have a little patience. You're learning how to move forward with patience, you know, in that particular situation. You're learning to wait on God rather than do things off of impulse. You're also learning to ask yourself questions like, you know, well, what did I miss the first time around when I went through this situation? What did I not see? Or, you know, what do I need to change moving forward. Sometimes rejection is a time to self-reflect and, you know, see what you need to change about how you're probably dealing with the situation. You know, you might be going about things the wrong way. And so in times of rejection and seasons where you feel like you're constantly getting rejected, maybe you need to like self-reflect and see how you can change or see how you could do things differently moving forward. And so the word tells us, don't be anxious about anything. So that means in those times where you are being told no constantly, that you shouldn't worry about whether it's going to work out or not, because the word says that, don't be anxious about anything. Matthew 6:26 says, look at the birds of the air, for they neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not more valued than they? Which of you by worrying can add one cubit to his stature? And this just means that God will make a way for you regardless of your situation, because he knows the things that you need. And sometimes we kind of get those things confused. The things that we want aren't necessarily the things that we need. And God is going to always make sure that you have the things that you need. But he loves you enough to also, you know, sprinkle a little of things that you want on there. It's just about being patient. It's just about having faith. And it's just about trusting the process and trusting God's way and realizing that, you know, things aren't going to go our way all of the time. And worrying and, you know, being anxious about a situation can actually cause something. It can make a mountain out of a molehill. It can cause a situation that was meant to be so small and, you know, just blow it out of proportion because, you know, you're all in your head and you're just thinking the worst about a situation that was never supposed to be, you know, be that big in the first place. So let's just go back up to the part where it says, do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your request to God. So in situations where, you know, you get rejected, whether it be from like one bad breakup or multiple bad breakups, you didn't get approved for, you know, the car that you wanted, you didn't get the job you wanted, or you even didn't get into the school that you wanted to get into. Philippians 4:6, which is, you know, the verse we just went over, is really a good verse to reflect on, you know, and helping you in situations like that, because then you see what you need to do moving forward. Like, you see that you kind of need to pray more. You see that worrying about that situation, you know, it's not going to change the situation at all. And the part where it says, you know, come to God with prayer and thanksgiving, that just means that when you pray to God on situations, you have to pray as if he had already blessed you with that thing that you are praying for. You have to thank him in advance, like, thank you, God, for this car, you know, that you blessed me with, or you're going to bless me with. Thank you, God, for getting me into the school that I wanted to go to. Thank you, God, for blessing me with this particular apartment. You know, thank you, God. Come to him, reverencing him, and thanking him as though he has already blessed you with the things that, you know, you have been praying for. With all that being said, I do hope you all enjoyed this video today. I do hope that I was able to, you know, help shine some light on certain situations for people. I just want to say thank you all for tuning in. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And don't forget to tune in next week for another video.